Hello student, welcome to concept of chemistry. My name is Papnali. In this video I will teach you Hofmann reaction. This reaction is from the chapter amine. Now we can see what are the starting material, what are the reagents which required for Hofmann elimination and what is the product. First remember one thing, in Hofmann elimination we get less substituted product. For that we have to know what is the less substituted product and what is the more substituted product. This concept is very important. If double bond having all hydrogens, then it is less substituted. If it having one methyl and other hydrogen, then it is more substituted. When we compare this compound, this first compound and this second compound, second one is more substituted. Why? Because here methyl is attached to the double bond and more substituent is on the double bond, that is more substituted alkene. And in Hofmann elimination we get less substituted product, means less substituent on double bond. Here first one is less substituted, then second, then third. Third is more substituted. Why? Because here two methyl group is attached to double bond. Substituted means more substituent on double bond. Less substituted means less substituent on double bond. Here only hydrogens. Here two methyl group. Therefore it is more substituted. And in Hofmann elimination we get less substituted product. Now we can see what are the starting material. When tetraalkyl ammonium halide, tetra means 4, alkyl means R, ammonium means N plus, halide means X minus. When heated with moist silver oxide, moist silver oxide means Ag2O, it gives quaternary ammonium hydroxide. It gives quaternary means 4, quarter means 4. Quaternary ammonium hydroxide, ammonium means N plus, hydroxide means OH minus, means X is replaced by OH, which is Delisquens crystalline solid, means it is a crystalline solid, means its nature solid and crystalline and strongly basic like NaOH, KOH. Why it is strongly basic? Because it consists of OH minus. Then quaternary ammonium hydroxide on strong heating, when we heat this compound, it undergo beta elimination to give alkene. It undergo beta elimination and it gives alkene. This is the alkene. It is called Hofmann elimination, means beta elimination of quaternary ammonium hydroxide, it is called Hofmann elimination. The least substituted alkene is obtained as a major product. In contrast, Seitz-Zeff elimination. In Seitz-Zeff elimination, we get more substituted alkene, and in Hofmann elimination, we get less substituted alkene. Here, this is the starting material. Here, three substituent on the N plus. This is fourth one, but these three substituents are same. Therefore, name is NNN triethyl, three ethyl group. Therefore, triethyl propyl. This is propyl group. Nitrogen having positive charge. Therefore, it is called ammonium iodide. React with AgOH. Under heating moist Ag2O, it gives, as we know, the halide is exchanged with this OH. Here AgOH and we get here OH. This is the AgOH. This halide exchange with OH and this part is remain as it is. This part is same and this I is replaced by this OH and the byproduct is Ag plus and this I is react with Ag, that is AgI. Here charge on Ag is positive and charge on oxygen is negative because Ag present in D block, O present in P block, and from left to right negative charge increases. Here S block, here D block, here P block. electronegativity is increases left to right in oxygen family. In p block oxygen present and in d block Ag is present. Therefore, positive charge on Ag and negative charge on oxygen. Just exchange positive negative part. Here positive part N plus and negative part I minus. This I minus react with this positive Ag and byproduct is AgI. And this positive part N plus react with this OH and we get this hydroxide. That is here three ethyl group, that is N and N tri. This is triethyl propane, this is propane, ammonium hydroxide, nitrogen positive charge, therefore ammonium, this is hydroxide. Just exchange plus minus. Then here beta elimination take place under heating condition. What is mean by beta? This is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon. Here beta hydrogen is removed and we get CH3 CH double bond CH2 and this hydrogen react with this OH. Byproduct is H2O, but this is not Hoffman product because here substituent methyl substituent, that is it is more substituted, therefore it is Sedgep product. Then here is also beta, here is beta, here is beta. These substituent are same, therefore we consider one. Here three hydrogens, one I write like this manner. Here this hydrogen donates this electron here, therefore here double bond form, and the nitrogen positive charge neutralized by breaking this bond and we get CH2 double bond CH2, and this H take by this OH, byproduct is H2O. Here all are hydrogen, therefore no substituent. Here methyl substituent, therefore it is Sedgep product, and here less substituent, therefore it is Hoffman product. Hoffman product is less substituted, and all quaternary ammonium iodide gives Hoffman product, and other part like same as it is. Here is the propyl group. Here propyl, here lone pair of nitrogen, here CH2CH3, here CH2CH3, and the product is CH2 double bond CH. This lone pair, the positive charge on nitrogen is neutralized by breaking this bond, and this bond consists of two electrons. Two electron means this lone pair, this bond means two electron, two electron means lone pair, and this bond means two electron, two electron means one single bond. After breaking this bond, here double bond is formed. This is the double bond, and this OH minus take this proton, antiproduct is this and byproduct is this. Thank you. Please do not forget to like, subscribe my channel.